Hello and welcome to Microbial Laboratory. In this lab, we will try to understand Gunn oscillator output power as a function of frequency. So if you have directly came to this video, it is my request, please go back and see our earlier videos so that you can understand the generalized setup of microwave test bench and basic experiments which we have carried out with by using this particular microwave test bench. So the setup for this experiment is we have a Gunn power supply, Gunn oscillator, isolator, frequency meter and power meter. So this is the setup. You can see the block diagram. We have Gunn oscillator, power supply, isolator. We have removed this pin modulator because this is not used for this particular study. Then frequency meter, we have also removed slotted line because we have directly connected the signal to power meter instead of this VSWR meter. Okay, so I have set this Gunn bias voltage to some value 9.5 volts, and I will vary the Gunn oscillator micrometer plunger position so that it will change the cavity dimensions of this Gunn oscillator, which will result into generation of variable frequencies. So our objective is to change the micrometer position. So if you see the observation table overall, it has first column micrometer reading. So this is the micrometer reading, which is similar to your vernier caliper. Then we have second column, which is about the frequency measured using DRF. So this is direct readout frequency meter, which we have seen in our earlier videos. Then the next column is output power in dBm, and this power we will be measuring using this power meter. So actually we have connected a fixed attenuator of 5 dB. So this 5 dB attenuator we have to consider in our calculations. So this minus 24.5, which is the actual reading on output power meter, we have to add 5 dB signal, which is 5 dBm. So it will become minus 19.5 for this reading. And I have converted this into a milliwatt, equivalent milliwatt reading for this dBm power. So we have to change this micrometer plunger and observe the frequency variation as well as what is the output power. So you can come to this side to understand the calibration chart provided by the manufacturer and this micrometer plunger. So this is the calibration chart. If you see and vary the frequency plunger position, let us say I keep this now at 10 mm. So for this 10 mm, now I have set this plunger to 10 mm, and for the 10 mm reading from the calibration chart, you can see the output frequency will be 10.8 GHz. This calibration chart is given for 10 volt bias voltage. So similarly, if you change the position of this plunger, output frequency of this Gunn oscillator will changes. So that we have to study. Again, we can come to front side and now set the micrometer plunger to one position, let us say at 10. The same thing which I have just shown you. Bias voltage I have kept 9.5 volts, almost 9.5 volts. And I will try to see the output power. Reference level of this power meter, the minimum power which can be detected is minus 30 dBm. So roughly now I have set the micrometer plunger to 11 and I am getting the output power minus 25.6 dBm. Now as you know the concept of this frequency meter, if I rotate this frequency meter, there is one point when the frequency of this meter and frequency coming out of this oscillator and traveling down the waveguide will match, and if frequency of this signal and frequency of this meter will be exactly same, almost all energy will be captured by this meter and we will get very minimum reading or maybe a zero reading at the output. So now if I rotate this frequency meter slowly and at the same time I have to see if there are any changes on power meter. Yes, this is the point. You can just zoom to the display of power meter. Now it is minus 28, almost minus 29.6. You can come to frequency meter and see now your frequency meter is tuned to the frequency of the microwave signal which is traveling down the waveguide. And if I now rotate the frequency meter maybe clockwise or an anti-clockwise direction, output power will increase. So you can zoom to the display of power meter and now I will move the frequency meter in one direction and you will see that there is increase in power. So there is increase in power. Again I will come to the resonance point so that you will receive the minimum power, which is minus 29.4. And now if I move the frequency meter in other direction, again power will increase. So that is how you have to catch the point of resonance. And now come to the frequency meter and try to measure this frequency. As you know that in our earlier videos we have tried to demonstrate how frequency can be measured. So currently at this position you can see it is at this point it is exactly one division before of 10.35. So you know that one division is carrying 5 megahertz. So 10,350 minus 5 means 10,345. So that is the frequency for this particular position of micrometer plunger. So this way you have to note down the frequencies. I have noted for all the points. I will take one more reading. I will again change the micrometer position to some other point. Let us say Now I have kept it at 13 mm. And now you can see the power is being increased. And one more time I will try to move the frequency meter and catch the point of resonance. Yes, this is the point. You can slowly come to that. Here you get the minimum signal. And if you come to frequency meter and try to rotate it maybe clockwise direction, output power will increase. Again, if you come to the point of resonance and rotate the frequency meter in anti-clockwise direction, output power will again increases. So this is the point of resonance where I am getting the minimum reading. And now one more time, try to measure the frequency. So if you come to this point, it is exactly 9.68 gigahertz, that is 9680 megahertz. So this is the way how you can measure the frequency by changing the micrometer plunger. So I have recorded for 5 readings, micrometer position 11, 13, 14, 15 and 17. And I have measured the frequency using direct readout frequency meter and recorded the output power from power meter. And I have added the 5 dB attenuation and converted that into a milliwatt reading. So now you are ready to plot the graph between output power versus frequency. So on x-axis, you can see this is Gunn oscillator output power as a function of frequency. So on x-axis, I have taken scale as a 1 cm is equal to 100 MHz. And on y-axis, 1 cm is equal to 0.0100 milliwatt. So this, with this scale, I have taken the readings. And you can see, let us say for 11, which is 9960 MHz. So 9960 MHz, I got the output power 0.0112. For 9960, I got the output power 0.0112. So you can come here, 9960. So this is 9.8, this is 9.9, and 60 megahertz ahead of that. And here I have 0.0100, so two divisions ahead of that. So this is the point of 9960. One more point I will show you, 9300. So for 9300 megahertz, output power is 0.0630 milliwatt. So this is 9.2, so it is 9.3, and the output power is 0.0630. So this is 0600, and two divisions ahead of that will be 630. So for 9.3, it is 0.0630. So this way, I have located all these points for respective frequencies and tried to join them, which gives us the response of Gunn oscillator output power as a function of frequency. So that's all for this video. See you in the next video. Thank you.